Leadership is fundamentally the art of bringing out the best in other people. And that means creating systems and structures which unleash human potential. It's not about ego, it's not about necessarily charisma. It's about the interdependent relationship between the leader and the people being led. And it's creating an environment where everyone can be true to themselves and reach their potential. That may sound simple. In practice, that's not easy to do.
Well, I think that a successful leader is one that knows that their success depends on the skills and abilities of those around them. What we also know is that one of the predictors of organisational performance is the employee line of sight. So this means every employee in an organisation understands how they directly contribute to the goals and the objectives of their company. And so it takes a leader with, and this is not just the CEO, but every leader in an organisation, it could be the first line supervisor, middle managers and executives, need to be able to communicate to staff how they directly contribute to organisation success.
The basics of leadership, I would say, are probably in holding somebody else accountable for what they promised to deliver on. I get students to work with people from different backgrounds, different personality types, different methods of operating. Some of them are full-time jobs, some of them have full-time jobs, some of them are full-time students. They have to learn to negotiate a lot of obstacles in order to achieve that common goal. And sometimes that takes a lot of leadership to step up and say, okay, here's what we promised to deliver on this last week. Where is everybody? How do we divide up this work, allocate it to different people, hold them accountable for doing it or not doing it?
Look, I like to believe that leadership is something that you can teach and that you can learn over time. And I think some of the most successful leaders that we have grown and evolved as a leader as their experience goes on. I think that the key attribute of a successful leader is being able to learn. Being able to reflect on your experiences and think about, well, what would I do differently next time?
I believe good leadership can be taught. We look at a whole lot of different aspects of leadership, but it really starts with ourselves. It really starts with understanding who we are, understanding our own strengths and weaknesses. All of us have both, and it's acknowledging the reality of those strengths and working on developing any weaknesses we might have, but all of us in that situation. So we start from the inside out, and that gives our students a better sense of what it really means to be a leader.
Not only is learning important for a leader, you need to be adaptable. So in one situation, you might be quite directive, because it's a crisis, it's an emergency, and it requires a leader to step up and make a decision. In other circumstances, you need to be more consultative and collaborative and genuinely seek input from others and make a consultative decision. So the leader needs to be flexible and be able to adapt to the different styles as required by the environment.